Chicken salad.
Ugh.
Cheese omelet?
Cheese, French fries, and a nice cold bottle of beer.
I'll see. Mike, cold roast beef?
Okay. Be right there.
75, 74, 73.
Second lunches, color-keyed disposable dishes, all part of the instant society of tomorrow, a society rich in leisure and taken for granted comforts. At the turn of the next century, most food will be stored frozen in individual portions. The computer will keep a running inventory on all foodstuffs and suggest daily menus based on the nutritional needs of the family. When the meal has been selected, the various portions are fed automatically into the microwave oven for a few seconds of de-thawing or warming. The house of 1999 will be virtually maintenance-free. A central atmospheric system will maintain constant year-around temperatures and control humidity, bacteria, pollen, and dust. Clothing of the non-disposable variety will be stored in cleaning closets, where a chemical vapor atmosphere and an ultrasonic vibrator will remove dirt particles. Fingertip shopping will be one of the many homemaker's conveniences. This video console will be channeled into the store of her choice. There, a camera will scan a display of wares, which she will select by push button. Another part of this console is a household monitor screen, which maintains a watch on critical areas in the house, swimming pool, or yard. What the wife selects on her console will be paid for by the husband at his counterpart console. All bills and transactions will be carried out electronically. A central bank computer will debit the family's account the amount of purchases and credit the department store, for example, informing the family's home computer at the same time. Father, at the touch of a button, receives an instantaneous printed copy of his budget, the amount of taxes he owes, the payments left on the car, and so forth. All documents and household records are available on the video screen for immediate reference. Also at his disposal is an electronic correspondence machine, or home post office, which allows for instant written communication between individuals anywhere in the world. To maintain these and hundreds of complex electronic circuits, a monitor checks all circuits every few seconds, inserts a backup circuit if and when trouble develops, and alerts the communal service agency for replacement. The Home Energy Center with its fuel cell, furnishes power, provides absolutely pure water, burns waste, and heats or cools the rooms. Too computerized? Too cold? The world of tomorrow will be as cold as sunlight puned through photochromic windows. It will be as wide as the ocean, which will provide not only recreation for the adventurers, but an increasing variety of hydro-cultured exotic fresh foodstuffs. And tomorrow will be as happy as music.
Hey, Chopin, what's up?
Oh, playing a song.
Ah, what's it called?
I forgot.
You faker. How about playing the song we learned yesterday?
Okay.
Let's augment this a bit, shall we?
Okay.
Yes, life will be richer, easier, healthier as space-age dreams come true. As part of his everyday regime, Michael Shore enters this home health center. He lies for perhaps 15 seconds on a kind of medical couch. His weight, temperature, pulse, respiration, blood pressure, and electrocardiogram are routinely recorded. At the same time, his body is scanned for any isolated temperature pockets that signal oncoming disease or a localized infection. At the end of the examination period, the computer calculates the amount of exercise necessary to balance Mike's food intake and maintain proper muscle tone.
Exercise requirements: 8.5 minutes bicycle, 6 minutes programmed calisthenics.
Oh, that's ridiculous. This thing can make a mistake, you know.
Your weight increase over 30 days, 1.1 kilograms. Repeat exercise requirements. 8.5 minutes bicycle, 6 minutes programmed calisthenics. Confirm, please. Confirm, please.
The computer now relays any important physical changes to a central community medical center, where Mike's personal physician will be alerted for further diagnosis. At conclusion of the exercise period, the pertinent data are again recorded for comparison with pre-exercise measurements. The results are again forwarded to the community medical center for further study if necessary. If the computerized life occasionally extracts its pound of flesh, it holds out some interesting rewards.